Hey guys, it's Regman Cosplay. I have a piece of my Mandalorian cosplay costume. This is my voice amp. I'll put a picture of it, the one that I bought, up on the screen, and I will put the link to the exact one that I got, so if you like it, then you can get one for your own Mandalorian, Stormtrooper, cosplay, anybody that really wears a helmet that you kind of want to be able to project your voice. And also, I'm going to try to be able to play some lines right from The Mandalorian through the voice amp while I'm at cons or wherever I'd be using the costume. And I don't know how good the audio is going to be on this, so I don't know how well you're going to be able to perceive the audio in here. I don't know if this comes with batteries. And if it doesn't, hopefully I have the right kind of batteries, so I'll be able to actually show you how loud it is and stuff like that. Yeah, I haven't seen it yet. Obviously, the box isn't open. Just went and got it out of the mailbox. So I hope it's going to be good. If not, then I can always return it and grab a different one. But I did see some really good reviews, and somebody said it was really good for their Stormtrooper cosplay. And they even said, or it could be used for The Mandalorian, which is the purpose that I'll be using it for. And on this channel, I'll be going over I'll be going over the process of me building my Mandalorian cosplay throughout probably the year or so that it's going to take me to build it, due to it being a very complex costume, a very expensive costume. And then I'll show you guys how I do each individual piece that I have to customize or buy, and show you how it works. And then if you want to do your own Mandalorian cosplay, then you won't have to search for stuff and information like I did. You can just watch this video and the other videos and get that information right from me. And you get my honest opinion, right? Obviously, this isn't any sponsorship or anything like that. So if it doesn't work, it's not very good. I'm not gonna lie to you, so let's get right into it. So, it comes in this pretty cool little yellow and black box. It is made by Mifa, however you pronounce that. I'm probably gonna call it Mifa, it's M-I-F-A, just enjoy. Don't know if that's something that they're like a company slogan or something. I don't know what that is, but the design of the box looks really cool. There we go. Okay. Okay, and then here is the speaker. I did see a lot of reviews saying that it was a lot smaller than they thought, which in this purpose is actually a lot better, because this will be a lot easier to conceal in your costume, as you don't just want like a speaker hanging out somewhere, right? So I'll be able to put this on my belt or hide it in a pouch or under like my cape or wherever it is that you would want to put it. You could probably put it there. Okay. So it does look a lot like the picture. I don't know how well you can see that. If the video doesn't look so good, I'll post a picture up here on the screen. But it looks really nice. It has the speaker here on the front. Got all the buttons, right? Pause, skip forward, skip backward, shuffle, for if you were using it for music, right? It has a SD card, the volume gauge. Also how you turn it on. Microphone input and a belt clip, which I think is very helpful to be able to just attach it to you. And under that, you have, I assume this is the harness. Well, I'm not going to spend too much time on this because I'm not really going to use it. Okay. This is the headset that it comes with. So, mind my hair. I need to get a haircut. Okay. So it seems the cord coming out of it is wrapped in like cloth, which I haven't seen before, but I don't think that should affect the quality at all. And worst case scenario, right, if the headset was really bad or you didn't really like how the mic sounded, you could always keep the speaker, and then you can get yourself a new headset made by somebody else. So it fits relatively comfortably on the head. Right? Whoa. Okay, so you can move the mic around. When you move it, it kind of makes a cracking sound, which kind of spooked me there for a second. I thought I broke it. But I assume because it's metal, that just makes a cracking sound the first time. So yeah, that is adjustable. This headpiece is not. It's hard plastic. This would probably break if I pulled it, but it still seems to fit pretty well. We'll get back to that later. Like I said, this cord isn't super long, right? But it should still reach to your belt relatively easily. I'm like 6'1", 6'2"-ish. And this should fit to my belt pretty easily. But if the length of the cord was an issue, you could always get aux cord extender, where it's like the one side's the female side and then it continues longer. And I'm also gonna be getting a Y splitter later so that I'll be able to run the headset mic and my phone through this at the same time, so I'll be able to play sounds. And then it also comes with this little charger cord, just your standard USB to micro USB cable. So you can use this with any charger. It does say that the charging time is, I think, 3 to 4 hours, but I'm sure that speed will be a little bit shorter if you use a fast charging block. But I also saw that a lot of the reviews said that the battery life was really, really long, which is good. And it comes with this little instruction manual, which I'm probably not going to read through. But yeah, so that's everything that comes in the box. I'm going to see if this is charged yet. There's a little dial on top. You turn the dial, and it does seem to be charged because there's a little blue light when you turn it on. And then to turn it up, I guess you just push it farther to the right. But right now we'll leave it really low. Because also a lot of people were saying that the volume is a little bit finicky. Like it'll go from really, really low to really, really loud really fast. So I want to test that out a little bit. Microphone does come with this little windshield. Here, I just had to turn the microphone because the audio input side is on the wrong side. There is a little raised up piece here on the microphone so you know which way to point it. I've seen on other microphones they have a little white line, so I might paint that white, but there is an indicator as to which way you should point it. I'm going to put this windscreen back on. It's just a standard little mic, right? Little windscreen. I'll put it back on. And then I also want to test how much it alters my voice to kind of sound more like Mandalorian. Okay. Hello. So, turn it up a little bit louder. Okay. Okay, yeah, so I only turned that up a little bit, and it's already decently loud, and I'm not getting a whole lot of wind resistance. The sound is pretty clear. It does sit really, really close to your face, but that also makes it a lot easier to use in a helmet, right? I don't think I'm gonna test it out on this just because it's not the right kind of helmet, right? The space is open, you would use this pretty much only for costumes that have a enclosed face, so you're not muffled trying to talk to people. It does alter my voice a little bit, but not a whole lot. But also, I've seen some other people, like, if you do lines from Star Wars, right, you're going to sound a lot more like the characters. I'll see if I can put my head back. Yeah, so it is decently concealable, right, because it only has that little headpiece. So it'll, and it's really tight to my head, right, it's not super bulky. I don't know how well you can hear me, but some other people did say it gets, yeah, I get a little bit of feedback, a little bit raspier when I get louder. But overall,
It does get pretty loud without having any issues. Hopefully you can hear this pretty well, especially now that I'm being projected right at you. Yeah. So the microphone does get a little bit twisted, pointed down. So just kind of fiddle around with it, get it to where you want it. So like right there. Sounds really, really good. So I can have it sit right there and then put my helmet on over it. Right. Sound quality overall right now, I'm super impressed. Okay guys, so that was my review of the Mypha voice amp for my Mandalorian cosplay. Like I said, it takes a little bit of fiddling around with on your face, but I could always get some sort of apparatus inside my helmet to maybe hold it there, or maybe my helmet will just be tight enough to kind of just hold it right there, because that's pretty much the best spot to have it, is right here, right on your mouth, and make sure it's pointed in the right direction so you get the best sound quality coming out of your microphone. But that's pretty much the only complaint I have about the microphone. Yeah, so I would definitely recommend this for your Mandalorian cosplay. And like I said, on this channel, I'll be uploading my updates for Mandalorian cosplay as I get different pieces, whether it be my armor or the cloth pieces or whatever it is. And I hope this helps you guys in your costumes, or if you need to use your voice amp or any of the other props that I'm making, or the ideas that I use in those videos to make other costumes, go ahead. Right, and this will also be on my Ko-fi page, which I will also link in the description if you want to go follow and support me on that. And thanks for watching.